They are your local experts in women's health. Nobody better than the Caldas Center to help those with infertility make it through the holidays.
Yeah, I can speak from experience. It is one of the most difficult times of this journey, and Dr. Rami Caldas is here. Good morning.
Good morning, ladies.
Let's talk a little bit about why the holidays can be so difficult for couples dealing with infertility. I mean, they might have been going through it for a number of years, but it's still so difficult during the holidays.
Oh, yeah, for sure, especially if they have been going through it for years. Mm-hmm. And because the holidays are so centered around children frequently and family and so on, and so that makes it very challenging because you get together with family and people unfortunately don't know what to say to you, and so it's really kind of important to control the information, and it's you have children, you know, the honesty of children, they may even make remarks that they don't mean to be insensitive, but come across as such. Mm-hmm. And, oh my goodness, the in-laws can be a challenge at this time.
Mm-hmm. When are my grandbabies coming?
Right.
We were asked that many times.
Right, yep. Right, and the pressure on a couple is amazing. And so it starts eroding at your feeling of self-worth. And that is what you consciously have to combat at this time. You have to recognize that you as a couple, you as an individual, have your self-worth, and you are valuable as a human being. Mm-hmm. And you have to, you know, make that conscious decision to carry on, to get out of bed every morning, you know, to be appreciative for what you do have. Mm-hmm. And that is the advice that we give at the Caldas Center.
Probably knowing you're not alone helps, too. How common is infertility, and when do we see a specialist?
Oh, my goodness. Infertility will affect 10 to 15% of the reproductive age population. And it's usually thought that after a year of trying, if you're less than 35 years old, it's reasonable to look into it, unless there's something obvious. Mm-hmm. Like, for example, if you're having killer periods, or if you are having cycles that are very irregular, like one time they're 30 days apart and then 60 days apart, well, you don't need to wait a year. There's clearly something going on there. Or if the partner or spouse has had a traumatic injury or something, you know, to the, when they were young or something like that, then you need to look into it sooner. And if you're over 35 and everything seems to be normal, then waiting 6 months to try to become pregnant is better than waiting a year before you start seeking evaluation, because time isn't quite on your side then.
So what are some of the causes of infertility?
Oh, the causes of infertility are, it can be male or female, okay? Mm-hmm. So about 40% of the time, there's actually a male factor more prevalent. About 40% is a female factor, and 20% of the time is a combination of both, all right? Mm-hmm. On the male front, there can be, like, low sperm count or low motility. Mm-hmm. And on the female front, it can be, you know, tubal factor or ovulatory factor, or something like endometriosis, which is causing a chronic inflammatory reaction inside, you know, that is preventing the egg and sperm from getting together. Mm-hmm. And the biology of it, certainly rationalizing it can help you think through it as you go through this time period in the holidays. But no amount of understanding is going to make every day great when you're going through the struggle at the holidays.
Let's briefly touch on how to cope through that. What are your top pieces of advice?
Oh, I think taking that time for yourself and recognizing that you have the right to care for yourself. And so it's okay to control the information that you share. You know, you don't have to take endless questions from families. Mm-hmm. You control the information. You take care of yourself. You decide what's normal. Don't let other people decide what's normal. And so, for example, maybe you go to a movie with adult friends instead of what you usually do. It's okay. You have the right to take care of yourself.
Yeah.
Okay?
And you should also embrace support as well, and I speak from experience in that realm too. So, if this is something you're struggling with, that you want a little talk about it, you can talk to the Caldas Center. Very easy, no referral needed.
It's 920-252-7015 or online. Start your journey at caldascenter.com. Thank you, doctor.
Thank you, ladies.